Apache, Blackhawk, Chinook. Parts for these storied helicopters and other aerospace and defense projects are the focus of McMellon Bros, a machine shop in Bridgeport, Connecticut, with a specialty in thread milling. Recently, however, the company found its growth inhibited by an all-too-common problem.
Our workforce is aging. The replacements are just coming up. There's a gap in skill. And what we've been faced with is trying to do more with less of a workforce.
A machine monitoring package called Accelerant helps McMellon Bros make the most of limited resources.
Accelerant has allowed us to identify areas where we're not utilizing our machinery to the full extent of, you know, its capacity. We've already invested in the people, we've already invested in the machinery. Accelerant is letting us get more out of what we already own and already have.
Although McMellon Bros has always strived to keep its manufacturing processes and technology modern, the same couldn't always be said of the way the company tracks machine and labor hours.
At best, we were one day lag on our reported data. An operator would work his day, fill out his timesheet, turn it in at the end of his day. The next morning, they'd be collected. And at that point, best case scenario, they were looked at right away. Sometimes they were logged in and not looked at for days, weeks.
Now, employees are free to focus on their jobs and the tasks at hand while Accelerant collects data automatically from machine tool CNCs.
With Accelerant now, we have the opportunity to look at the job as it looked 15 seconds ago. It's showing us the machine status right now. It's showing us how the machine is progressing throughout the day, how many parts we've gotten, how many parts he should have gotten, if there are problems happening.
After implementation, it didn't take long for the shop's use of the machine monitoring system to evolve.
It's really pushed us into the full scheduling and ERP. It's allowed us to start utilizing the ERP more to its potential.
Another example is the software's use as a communication tool between the shop floor and the front office.
So reason codes first came about because we were finding that we had gaps of idle time in our machine. It's not because we're not trying to produce parts. Usually there's a good reason why. So reason codes were born to kind of define that time, that downtime when a machine's not running, that's legitimate, be it inspection, tooling requirements, programming, or missing parts.
Read the whole story at mmsonline.com.